And good evening. I'm Ed Gargis alongside my very good friend Kevin Bishop. Got Tyler Wagner here in the booth, but you're getting ready to watch YAC or Dexter basketball live on YAC TV. We got Bernie Mules in town tonight in Dexter. The JV coming off a 20-point victory in the pregame. Played very well, but Dexter, they had a great Christmas tournament,
yes.
Kevin. Then kind of, well, in the championship game, including the championship game, had a three-game skid, came back with a big win Tuesday night. Whoever we played, up in Bloomfield, up in Bloomfield. And got recharged. Bernie Mules, not the typical Brad Botch, Jason Long team this year. They've struggled a bit at getting up and down the court somewhat. Don't have the ball handling that they've had in the past, so it's still going to be an interesting matchup. Got a couple of injuries on the Bearcats, so we're going to take a quick break for the national anthem. We'll be right back. And welcome back. A great rendition there by young Miss Flowers. Always enjoy hearing her sing.
Oh, she does an outstanding job. But rivalry game tonight, Ed, it could be all we want, even though Bernie is down a little bit this year. Typically a good game.
You bet. Bernie is down a little bit, but Dexter's kind of shorthanded.
Yeah.
Got an injury in Jason Gerald. Missing Adam Webb, and so they're going to be very, very limited off the bench. But Ryan Mayo stepped up in that Bloomfield game Tuesday night for a career game, and so be looking to see if he is come back with another repeat performance like that. It's going to be key to, I believe, to Dexter having another successful evening.
I agree.
And so we're getting ready to head with the starting lineups here. First, with Bernie Mules. Number two, Jace Burke, 5'8 junior.
A 6'2 sophomore and a forward, number 23, Nate.
Number 23, 6'2 sophomore, Nate Dillinger.
A 6'2 senior and a forward, number 40.
Number 40, 6'2 senior, Alex Whitehead. Alex is the only senior on this Bernie Mule team.
A forward, number 42.
Number 42, 6 foot sophomore, Gavin Brown. And number 44, 5'11 sophomore, Dalton Hobgood.
And now for your starting lineups for your Dexter Bearcats.
And starting for the Dexter Bearcats.
Starting in guard, a 5'10 senior, number 21.
Number 21, 5'10 senior, Jacob Pettigo. 5'9 senior, number 24, Ethan Flowers. Ethan Flowers with his highest point total of the year Tuesday night against Bloomfield. Number 25, 5'11 senior, Tyler Heil.
A 6 foot junior,
number 33, 6 foot junior, Ryan Mayo. Again, Ryan with his highest offensive output Tuesday night as well. And then the number 35, 6 foot sophomore, Gabe Jackson. Gabe Jackson really had a coming out party through the entire Christmas tournament.
Yes, he did.
And now the word is out throughout Southeast Missouri. You don't front him. You don't play him from behind. You do both.
Yes. And, yeah, and he's going to be double teaming.
Absolutely. Kenneth figured that out the second half of the championship game. Perryville came in and did it all night long, as well as Woodland did it all night long that following Friday in that 0-for-3 skid. Bloomfield tried to do it as
held
well.
Him to 6 points.
But Tyler Hall and Ryan Mayo picked it up offensively and overcame, you know, made the deficit up of what Gabe did in the Christmas tournament. So Dexter controls the tip here tonight. Flowers over to Pettigo. And there you see the two bodies on Jackson. They get one on him, they go right over the top. Jackson with the quick layup to get the scoring going for the Bearcats. Hopgood. Over to Whitehead. Whitehead. Now number two, Burke. Back to Whitehead. Hopgood. Loses control, so turnover.
If I'm not mistaken, Whitehead actually went to Dexter until his sophomore year or until his junior year?
I know he was at Bernie in his junior year. Okay. I do not recall if he was there as a sophomore or not. Flowers now with the ball. Out, top of the key from the high point, won't go. Rebound Whitehead, gets it over to Hopgood. Dillinger, pass to Whitehead, Hopgood. Now there's steal by Gabe Jackson. Good defense, good hands by the big guy. Pettigo off the glass for his first bucket.
I think Pettigo's had a nice season this year, been really consistent as far as points-wise, just having an outstanding senior season.
Yes, and there we go. Good defense, Pettigo there, no foul. Gabe Jackson policing up the rebound in the process. Pettigo was a little slow getting started offensively Tuesday night, but he came up with two big threes in the third quarter. And then Guzman checks in, number three for the Mules, but that kind of started the separation point as those two teams, that being Dexter and Bloomfield, were tied after three. Nice rebound there by Alex Whitehead, getting position on Jackson. And then Dexter outscored Bloomfield 22-5 in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, I mean, that game, you know, if you got to see it on YHC or you were there, I mean, it was much closer than the score indicated. I mean, just big fourth quarter by the Bearcats.
Whitehead for three, won't go. Rebound Jackson, contested there by Guzman, no foul. And Flowers with the floater gets the bounce and the bounce and the bounce goes in. And with that, we got timeout Bernie, 5:33 in the first. We're going to take a quick break.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Your Pizza Hut favorites, just $5 each when you order two or more.
So, two medium pizzas, just $5 each?
Yes.
Well, all right.
Can we get Wing Street Wings for $5 each?
Yes.
Can we get pasta? And how about a Hershey's cookie?
Yes and yes.
Can I get pizza for the whole team?
You got it, Mr. Cuban. Just $5 each.
Yes!
It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu, only at Pizza Hut.
Hi, I'm Cecil Weeks of Quality Center in downtown Malden, where we proudly serve the Tri-County area, Stoddard, Dunklin, and New Madrid County. I'm really excited to now offer Serta Mattresses, America's number one mattress seller. We carry over 10 different models of comfort level, from soft, firm, and everything in between. and we carry a wide selection of appliances, including refrigerators, dishwashers, rangers, washers, and dryers, and a full floor of fine furniture from Jackson and Catnapper. We welcome you to see our selection of mattresses, furniture, and appliances at Quality Center, downtown Malden.
And welcome back. You see the Burning Mules taking the court. It'll be their ball as looks like Burke will inbound it underneath. Dillinger ahead on down court. Guzman will work with Burke to get the ball down the court. Dexter in 1-3-1. Over to Whitehead. Back out to Guzman. Now Burke finds Dillinger for three short. Rebound Mayo. Mayo guarded by Whitehead, but gets his composure, gets the ball down court. Heil back out to Flowers. Over to Heil. Now Pettigo looking down low. Finds Jackson, spin move. Nice, nice. All alone there at the goal. Excellent footwork there by the big guy. And Dexter's out to an 8-0 lead with 440 to go here still in the first quarter. Guzman over to Dillinger. And number 42 checked in, or that's Gavin Brown. He's going to be called for the block.
Mules foul number 42, Gavin Brown, his first, team foul number one.
So kind of pushed off on the contact. You'll get called every time on that.
And Ed, I got a score update from Mayor Bill Aslan. Bloomfield's down at Malden tonight. At the end of the first quarter, Bloomfield leads Malden 18-14.
Congratulations, Wildcats. Flowers for three. His first. Now, Ethan Flowers, well known for his ability behind the arc, but Tuesday night he exerted himself driving the lane and scored almost as many in the paint.
How many points did he have?
He had 17, I believe. Maybe 19, but 17. And there, Flowers just leads Pettigo half a step too much. Two-on-one break. Coach Dowdy saying, hey, we don't have to be that way, guys. Trust me, he's saying that. You don't see it on TV.
Yeah.
And Hobgood checks back in for Burt. Guzman stays in. Guzman guarded by Pettigo. Gets it over to Hobgood for three. In and out, won't go. Rebound Dillinger up. Won't go. Rebound Dillinger off the glass. Still won't go. And then he gets a third chance. Third time's a charm for Dayton Dillinger. Great effort there by the sophomore.
Yeah. That's the thing about a young team like this. They're going to take their lumps now, but the experience they're getting at the varsity level only going to make this Burney team better next couple years.
Yes, and there's a handful, more than a handful of players at that Burney JV level that can shoot the three and dribble the ball. So, like I said, we'll call it a rebuilding year.
Yeah.
Coach Bosch, for several years, he's just been reloading.
Yeah.
He finally had a rebuilding year, but his players are going to play hard.
Yeah, they always play hard.
Now Pettigo working against Hobgood. Jumper won't go. Rebound Whitehead. Pushes it out front to Dillinger. And all alone for the layup.
2 points for Nate Dillinger.
Good heads up play there by Whitehead. Recognizing Dillinger had broke it. The Bearcats had not. Jackson with the ball. Now out to Mayo. Flowers. And the floater. Gets the roll and in and out. Jackson with the rebound and the back at bucket. He'll try the traditional three. Whitehead called for the foul. His first, team foul number two. Bingo.
Jace Burke.
Bernie had a little bit of momentum there. Nice shot by Dillinger.
Dillinger, 6 points, accounting for all the Mule scoring. Mayo now working against Dillinger, or looking against Dillinger. There's Kyle up top, back to Mayo. Flowers guarded by Burke. Back over to Mayo. Kick out to Pettigo for three. A little strong. Rebound, yeah. Guzman, or Burke. Gets it up front to Pettigo, or Dillinger, stolen by Pettigo. But back to the Mules. Brown, Hobgood, and Burke look. 1:17 to go here in the first. Brown up. And Pettigo, contact there. He's going to get a call for the foul. His first against the Bearcats. And we'll see Gavin Brown at the line shooting two.
Bearcat foul, number 21, Jacob Pettigo. His first team foul number one. At the line for the Mules, shooting two, Gavin Brown.
Good crowd on hand here tonight.
Yes.
Bernie and Dexter usually always travel well when they play each other.
1 point for Gavin Brown.
Brown not able to connect on the second. Flowers now skip pass from Mayo back to Jackson. And
good luck. 2 points for Gabe Jackson from Ethan Flowers.
Whitehead working against Mayo. Finds Hobgood. Guarded by Flowers and Mayo. Now Whitehead for three, strong. Dillinger with the rebound.
Dillinger just.
Jackson with the rebound this time. He's going to bring it up the court. Over to Pettigo. Kicks out to Flowers. Gives it back.
Coach Dowdy calling for one shot.
Under 15 seconds.
Yep, there you go. Jackson with 9 points here in the first. Over to Flowers, down to four. Pettigo for three, in and out, won't go. So after the break, or after one, Bearcats on top, 16-7. We'll take a break and we'll be back.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, talk to State Farm agent Chris Brannon in Dexter. State Farm is there.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with a small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
And welcome back. You see the Bearcats getting final instruction. They take the court. So really the first quarter was a lot about Gabe Jackson getting alone underneath. 9 points to lead the Bearcats, 5 for Flowers to include a three-pointer, and 2 to Jacob Pettigo. And really Nate Dillinger with a lot of energy and a lot of focus getting the Bernie Mules going. 6 of the 7 points after the Mules being down 8-0.
Yeah, I like Nate Dillinger's style of play there in the first quarter.
Burke back to Dillinger. Over to Brown now, working against Jackson. Look at baseline, won't find it. Flowers with the turnover. Mayo all the way goes hard. Rebound Jackson. Pettigo now looking to set the offense. Mayo gets it to Jackson, kicks out to Howell. Back to Pettigo. Now Flowers finds Heil up top.
Pulling three people in Gabe right now.
Gavin Brown's got his hands full. So his teammate's saying, that's all right, we'll help you out. Pedigo, jump stop, shot, jumper won't go. Rebound Dillinger. Brown, jump defense by Jackson. Tip, rebound Dillinger. Burke for two, three, short, rebound Pedigo. Pedigo pushes the tempo. Flowers thought about it. Pedigo will. In and out, won't go. Rebound to Brown. Good job by Brown. Only 6 foot, so giving up 5 inches on Gabe Jackson, but got position that time. Whitehead now over to Brown, stolen. Well, Whitehead went to Hopgood. Good job, Pedigo. And with that, we got another timeout. Dexter. So with 6:12 to go, we'll take a break and we'll be back.
Save time this holiday season and shop the Ford Friends and Neighbors event at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
You've always had an inside deal with us.
We have got lower prices on our website, like this F-350, now only $52,346. This F-150, now only $31,534. This 2015 Taurus, now only $26,388.
Whether you come take a test drive or visit us on the web, you get the real inside deal here at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
You just can't do it anymore, but you want to stay in your own home. Bales is the place to call. Bales is committed to helping people like you to maintain your independence and live your life on your terms with dignity. Bales can help with your family getting paid for taking care of you. There is no need to live anywhere but our own home with Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services there to help. Just call 888-449-0949 or stop by 719 Tico Road in Kennett to find out more. Bales, Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services, serving Dunklin, New Madrid, Pemiscot, and Stoddard counties.
And welcome back. 6:12 to go here in the first half. Bernie ball. We see Hopgood dribble the ball down. Working against Flowers. Good D by Flowers. Finds Dillinger, guarded by Heil. Kick out to Brown from the free throw line. Won't go. Mayo with position and the rebound. Pedigo splits the defense, kicks out to Flowers, guarded by Burt. Back up top to Mayo. Over to Heil now, looking down low to Jackson, gets up top to Flowers. Bernie coming out of that zone a bit. Kind of still in the 2-3, but they're manning up on Flowers. Heil over to Mayo, jumper short. Flowers with the rebound. Heil finds Mayo again. Flowers for three, short. The rebound Whitehead. Good, again, good job by Brown. Tying up Jackson away from that rebound. Burke, Brown, Hopgood, back to Burke. Whitehead, looks baseline. Good defense by Ethan Flowers, anticipating the handback. And there's Pedigo now with 6:04. Push this lead to 13. We got timeout Bernie, 4:37. We're going to take a break and we'll be back.
I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. I'm for working hard for what you get and then protecting what you've got. Your home, your vehicles, your life. I'm for making an honest living and taking pride in what you do, and for giving back to the community I call home. I'm for serving my clients with the respect and dignity you would expect from the farmers that started this company. And though I know you probably hope you never need me, I'm here for you when you do. I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent, and if you're a Missourian, I'm for you.
And welcome back. See Coach Bosch, final instruction here, as you hear the buzzer as well. Bearcats pushed their lead to the highest of the night at 13. I believe in the first quarter they had an 8-point lead. So again, Jacob Pettigold starting to find his shot. He's have all 4 points for the Bearcats here in the quarter. And just as the Burning Mules were slow getting on the scoreboard in the first quarter, they've been shut out here in this first half of the second.
And had another score update. Bloomfield Wildcats lead the Malton Green Wave 28-25 at the half.
Dillinger, a little strong, rebound Heil. Good defense there by the Bearcats as Dillinger had the head fake, but nobody left their feet. Jackson now with the spin. He realized Brown was off balance. Said, hey, I think I could do something here.
Yeah.
Got himself squared up. Now has 11 points in the ball game to account for half of the Dexter Bearcat offensive output. Hopgood, guarded by Flowers. Skip past Burke. Now at top to Guzman. We're guarded by Mayo. And there, Burke stepped out of bounds. Pass a little wide. Unofficially, that now be six turnovers by the Mules here in the first half. Guzman gets a break. Whitehead back in. Or maybe it was Guzman back in, excuse me. Crumley in the game. Number 12 for the Bearcats. To Jackson now, another.
2 points for game, Jackson.
Burke, Whitehead, Hopgood. Hopgood for three, won't go, long rebound, policed up by Brown. Over to Hopgood now. Dillinger looking to drive, won't go. Good defense by the Bearcats, sealing off the lane. And a three-pointer just short, rebound Jackson. Pettigold slows it down, under three now. Finds Flowers, guarded by Burke, way up top. Flowers loses the handle, Burke loses his footing. Crumley back to Pettigo. Flowers now drives, finds baseline, finds Crumley, won't go. Policed up by Hopgood. Good look, just didn't get the bounce that time, but Jacob. Dillinger kicks out to Whitehead for three. In and out, bounce again. Bernie just not getting any of the bounces from behind the arc. Now we approach 2 minutes to go here in the first half. The Burning Mules yet to score in the second quarter. As the Bearcats have extended their 9-point lead to 17. Rebound Dillinger. Finds the baseline, left hand won't go. Foul's gonna be on Gabe Jackson, his first. Second team foul now against the Bearcats, but Dillinger on the line shooting two.
Bearcat foul number 25, Tom Kyle. His first team foul number two.
We see number 35 getting ready to check in.
Shooting two, Nate Dillinger.
Riley Wells, 6'7 junior.
6'7.
Substitution number 35, Riley Wells. And then for the Bearcats, number 33, Ryan Mayo.
And Ryan Mayo checks back in for the Bearcats.
I'm wondering if Riley's any relation to Gary Wells. I know they're a Bernie family and been in that. And old Gary's about 6'6", so.
And Mayo gets on the scoreboard. He may very well be, Kevin, as a Duncan County native, not too familiar with all these Stoddard County families yet. And Dillinger for three.
Dillinger just having an outstanding night individually.
Possession arrow in favor of
Dexter, it looks like.
Yes, we'll stay with Dexter.
Good hustle play there by Burt.
Flowers back out to Mayo. 1 minute now. Over to Heil. Dillinger saying, I'll give you a step. Down low to Mayo. Up off the glass, won't go. Rebound Jackson. And the putback. 15 points now for Gabe Jackson. 40 seconds to go. Hobgood working against Flowers. Dillinger guarded by Heil. Tries to get inside of Whitehead, won't go. Another turnover, Burning.
Coach Dowdy calling for one shot again.
More likely to get it with 15 seconds than he was with 45. Pettigo, Flowers, 5 seconds. Mayo for three. Long rebound, Dillinger. And at the half, it's going to be your Bearcats on top, 28-12. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your halftime pleasure, the Dexter Kickin' Cats!
Flip it over.
While I may not be able to do your job, I'm here to help with all of your commercial or home lending. Our loans are simple and inexpensive. I'll get the job done with personal financial assistance at First National Bank. believing in community, and preparing for the future.
It's nice, but you know what? I think I'm going to stick to the banking job.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative. I'm working hard in Jefferson City, fighting to support access to health care for senior citizens, fighting to remove government from our schools and allowing our teachers to teach our children without their interference. I'm working hard to support job growth and our economy, and I appreciate very much your support. If you have any questions or comments, please email me at tylerhubrecht@house.mo.gov.
Edward Jones, this is Shirley speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hey, Neil. How are you? How was the trip?
With nearly 7 million investors.
Right here. Hold on one sec.
You'd expect us to have a highly skilled call center.
Kevin, Neil Hawley's on line one.
Okay, great.
And we do. It's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
A bigger house or looking to buy your first? Go with a lender you can trust. Montgomery Bank. Our mortgage professionals are ready to help you with low rates and great service.
Folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tour us. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman, and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Tonight's game brought to you in part by Bank of Advance. Bank of Advance has four locations to serve you in Dexter, Bell City, Advance, and Chaffee. The Bank of Advance wishes luck to all teams and understands the preparation, practice upon practice, for each game of the long season. Bank of Advance, where a handshake still matters. Member FDIC.
When there's no light at the end of the tunnel, no hope, I just lose the will to move ahead.
God will supply you with the strength to do all that needs to be done on that day. So let go and trust in Him.
I'm so glad I don't have to go it alone anymore.
Let the Lord Jesus be your strength right now. A message from the First Baptist Church of Dexter, Missouri.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
Hey, welcome back. It's halftime. Got a minute here, but really, Kevin, much like what we talked about, Gabe Jackson and the Dexter Bearcats.
Yeah, he's been tough. Excuse me. He's been tough to stop. Bernie is starting to, you know, pull three people down on him, but he's still been being able to make an impact underneath. And then big play by Ethan Flowers tonight. He's having a really good game. But Bearcats are coming out tonight, playing solid. And, you know, this Bernie team continuing to battle, but they just don't have the depth to
right.
hang in there.
Well, and that too, Pettigo and Flowers getting it going outside the perimeter there or out by the arc. That's going to force, and it did, Bernie had to adjust. You know, they started out just packing it in, having three guys there on Jackson. But Ryan Mayo getting a little active on the offense as well. It forces that, those bodies to come out of that paint down low and get out and guard those bodies. And so then tribute to Dexter, they've done a great job recognizing it and feeding Gabe. But then Gabe, too, great footwork for the big guy, getting his position, getting some rebounds, a lot, especially on the defensive end, but on the offensive end as well for some putbacks. Leading all scorers, he's got 15, 6 for Jacob Pettigo, 5 for Ethan Flowers, and 2 for Ryan Mayo to account for the 28 points for the Bearcats. And the Mules, their offense has been all Nate Dillinger. He's got 11 of their 12, and Gavin Brown was 1 of 2 from the free throw line for the 12th point. And they are going to have to get some output from somebody else. Nate Dillinger, he's a very talented young man. It's going to be a great fun watch over the next couple of years for Bernie, but he's going to have a little bit of help.
Yeah.
Hobgood out. Flowers out on Hobgood. Spins, drives, does not get the roll, but gets the foul. He'll shoot 2. I believe that's going to go against Flowers. That'll be Ethan's first. Number 1 against the Mules. Only 2 fouls against the Bearcats, only 2 against Bernie in the first half. Man, Hobgood gets his first point.
And I just spotted Gary Wells in the stands and sent him a text. That is his nephew that's 6'7". So.
Rebound Jackson. Pettigo now. Guarded by Hobgood.
The next 5 minutes, half price.
Pettigo now guarded by Whitehead. Picked up by Hobgood. Finds Flowers. Kicks it back to Pettigo for 3. Count it. Pettigo now with 9 in the game.
3-point pass.
Dillinger, guarded by Heil. Over to Brown. Back to Hobgood. Gets the gold baseline, comes back. Runner won't go. Nice rebound by Heil. Heil's got tremendous length in him.
He does. With that long reach. Arms.
Flowers now. Over to Mayo for 3. All good. Mayo, his first 3. Now 5 points in the ball game. Whitehead, floater off the glass. Alex's first point to the game. That time, Mayo got greedy on the defense, or too aggressive, if you will, and allowed Hopgood to get freed, drive to the lane. And then the senior showing a nice touch. Yeah. Flowers with the drive. Count it. And he'll get tipped for the traditional and one.
Mules foul number 23, Nate Dillinger.
And Dillinger, his first. And team foul number 1 against Bernie here in the second half.
And the old-fashioned 3-point play for Ethan Flowers.
Flowers now with 8 in the ball game. Hobgood working against Flowers. Now Burt, guarded by Pettigo. Over to Dillinger, guarded by Heil. Brown. Hobgood for 3, got it.
3-point basket.
Didn't get any of the bounces in the first half. Didn't worry about a bounce on that one, Kevin. Nothing but net.
These Bearcats just still being patient at this point running their offense, and they've shown tendencies at times during the year. You know, when they've had a lead or trying to play from behind, get a little bit sloppy, but tonight continuing to slow it down.
Flowers for 3. Good.
3-point basket. Ethan Flowers.
That's his second. We got a full timeout. Dexter.
Bearcats.
5:05 to go here in the third. We'll take a break and we'll be back.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Your Pizza Hut favorites, just $5 each when you order two or more.
So, two medium pizzas, just $5 each?
Yes.
Well, all right.
Can we get Wing Street Wings for $5 each?
Yes. Can we get pasta? And how about a Hershey's cookie? Yes and yes.
Can I get pizza for the whole team?
You got it, Mr. Cuban. Just $5 each.
Yes!
It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu, only at Pizza Hut.
Hi, I'm Cecil Weeks of Quality Center in downtown Malden, where we proudly serve the Tri-County area, Stoddard, Dunklin, and New Madrid counties. I'm really excited to now offer Serta Mattresses, America's number one mattress seller. We carry over 10 different models of comfort level, from soft, firm, and everything in between. And we carry a wide selection of appliances, including refrigerators, dishwashers, rangers, washers, and dryers, and a full floor of fine furniture from Jackson and Catnapper. We welcome you to see our selection of mattresses, furniture, and appliances at Quality Center, downtown Malden.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you.
We're never having kids.
I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, talk to State Farm agent Chris Brannon in Dexter. State Farm is there.
And welcome back. It'll be a Bernie Mule ball. Guzman checks in. He'll inbound to Dillinger. Hopgood, Brown, and Burke still in the game for the Mules. The Bearcats still with their starting five. Dillinger loses his footing. Good hustle there by Burke. And a steal by Flowers. Flowers takes it all the way, dishes to nice pass to get Gabe Jackson going here in the third, his first bucket of the second half.
The senior Jacob Crumley about to check into the ball game for the Bearcats.
Burke for three, in and out, won't go, rebound Jackson. Flowers looks, pass to Pettigo. Good defense by Guzman.
Yeah, he's.
Mayo over to Heil. Heil splits the lane, pull up jumper, won't go, but he's fouled.
I know Coach Dowdy has told Heil, because a lot of teams have been giving him a little bit of cushion because they're backing down on Gabe. Coach Dowdy's told him, take a couple dribbles, pull that shot up. And you know, the other night, him and Mayo, traditionally the hustle players but not big point contributors, and kind of opened the game wide open for Dexter the other night.
Tyler gets on the scoreboard.
Bearcat substitution number 12, Jacob Crumley.
Yeah, Tuesday night, Heil and Mayo accounted for 13 points together. There's Heil. Getting it done at the charity strike.
Mule substitution.
Whitehead.
Alex Whitehead. In for the Bearcats, number 15. Dawson
Casty, as well as Jacob Crumley checking in for the Bearcats. Caston brings a lot of energy.
Yeah, he's a big-time hustle player.
And Flowers going to be called for the hand check. That'll be Ethan's second. Team foul number two.
24, Ethan Flowers.
Another scoring update. Bloomfield Wildcats lead the Malden Green Wave 34-32 at the end of the third quarter.
Burt now guarded by Crumley. Burt finds Dillinger, touch pass to Whitehead. Fouled by Dawson Caston.
Bearcat foul number 15. Dawson Caston, his first team foul number three. The line for the Mules shooting two, Alex Whitehead.
So Whitehead, his first trip to the charity stripe. Oh, three team fouls now against the Bearcats. Whitehead good on the second. Put him in the scorer's column now. Flowers to Mayo. Back to Flowers. A little strong. There's that hustle by Casting as Bernie Mule stood back, and we're going to let it go out of bounds. Mayo gets the roll. Mayo now 7 points in the ball game. Five in this half, or this quarter. Hobgood working against Flowers, spins, kicks it out to Whitehead, back to Hobgood. Mayo picks up. Dillinger for three, won't go. Good defense, Hiles. Mayo for three, a little strong, won't go. Good rebound, Hiles off the glass and in.
We just talked about those guys, and you know, Mayo comes up with a big shot, and then back down the floor, and Heil puts in a big rebound.
Tyler now with 4 points in the quarter and the game. Brown ducks the shoulder, but it's going to be a block on Heil, or maybe on Castor. Let's see.
Bearcat foul number 15, Dawson.
It does go against the sophomore, Dawson Castor. Team foul number four.
Substitution number three, Alex Guzman. Into the game for the Bearcats, number 21, Jacob Hennigo. And number 23, Ben Sindel.
23, Ben Sindel checking into the game for the first time. Whitehead all alone for three. Count it.
3 point basket, Alex.
Whitehead now 6 points in the game. Crumley looks. They're giving him some space. Heil. Tries to get it down. Nice pass. Yeah. Give gold there to Dawson. Dawson's in the scorer's block.
Good look. Good shot.
Dillinger pull up. Nice shot there for his first bucket of the second half. 2 minutes to go. Better goes Ben Sindel for three. Crumley the rebound and the putback.
Jacob.
2 points. Jacob Crumley.
Jacob looks good. A little bit fired up, and so does the student section. Jacob, the senior.
Starts to say, good to see the senior getting some points.
Yep.
And we got a foul.
Here we foul number 25, Tyler Howell. His second.
Tyler Howell.
At the line for the Mules, shooting two. Nate Dillinger. Points for Nate Dillinger. Timeout, Mules.
Yeah, Bernie calls timeout, so we're 1:34, one to go. We'll take a break.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with a small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
Save time this holiday season and shop the Ford Friends and Neighbors event at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
You've always had an inside deal with us.
We have got lower prices on our website, like this F-350, now only $52,346. This F-150, now only $31,534. This 2015 Taurus, now only $26,388.
Whether you come take a test drive or visit us on the web, you get the real inside deal here at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
Hey, welcome back. Ball's going to be with Bearcats. Isle inbound right below us here.
And the Bearcats have kind of pulled out of reach.
26-point lead with a minute 30 to go in the third. Single, Crumley, Pettigold. Guzman, very active on the defense.
Yeah, good hustle.
Just short of the steal. Sindel saying, yeah, I'm going to make you come out on me.
I like to see a kid that will continue to give you all he's got, even when you're down.
Crumley trying to get it to Pete Dawson. Dawson went left, Crumley went right. Burke inbound to Guzman. He'll walk the ball up. Over to Dillinger. Back to Guzman. Finds Burke. Guarded by Sindel. Whitehead finds the baseline. Kicks back out to Brown. Dillinger for three. Short. Rebound Crumley. Pedigo guarded by Guzman. That time contact. That'll be Guzman's first. Three team fouls against the Mules.
Mules foul number three, Alex Guzman. His first, team foul number three.
Dalton Hobgood checks in for Gavin Dalton Brown. Sindel inbounds to Heil. Howell drives, pull up, won't go. Nice defense, got a hand on it, Dillinger.
Good rebound there by Crumley.
Now Crumley guarded by Hobgood. Pedigo between the legs. Pull up jumper, a little long. That's going to be into three, a 26-point lead for the Bearcats, 52-26. We'll be back.
You just can't do it anymore, but you want to stay in your own home. Bales is the place to call. Bales is committed to helping people like you to maintain your independence and live your life on your terms with dignity. Bales can help with your family getting paid for taking care of you. There is no need to live anywhere but our own home with Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services there to help. Just call 888-449-0949 or stop by 719 Tico Road in Kennett to find out more. Bales, Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services, serving Dunklin, New Madrid, Pemiscot, and Stoddard counties.
I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. I'm for working hard for what you get and then protecting what you've got. Your home, your vehicles, your life. I'm for making an honest living and taking pride in what you do, and for giving back to the community I call home. I'm for serving my clients with the respect and dignity you would expect from the farmers that started this company. And though I know you probably hope you never need me, I'm here for you when you do. I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent, and if you're a Missourian, I'm for you.
And welcome back. Television production 099. All right, so ball's going to be with Bernie. Take it out there at big court. Excuse me, going to be with Dexter. Pedigo inbound to Mayo. Back to Pedigo. Loses the handle. Heads up to Guzman. Nice little dribble.
Yeah, nice finish there by Guzman.
Gets him in the scorer's block for the game.
Bearcats back with the starters here to start the fourth quarter.
Guzman almost with another steal. Ball stays with the Bearcats. Be inbounded by Heil underneath their goal. Inbound Pedigo and Guzman ties it up. Possession arrow in favor of the Mules.
Guzman continues to play hard here in the second half.
Burt now back to Guzman. Jump stop, shot, foul. Go against Jacob Pedigo, I believe. That is his second.
Second. Team foul number six.
Guzman shooting two. The 16 fouls against Bearcats now. Rebound. Jackson, Pettigo now, picked up by Guzman again. Over to Mayo, guarded by Hobgood, back to, or to Heil. Heil tries to feed it inside, just out of the reach of Jackson. Hobgood, guarded by Flowers. Now Whitehead finding the baseline. Hobgood three, won't go. Rebound Jackson. Flowers working the ball down the court. Finds Mayo. Heil. Coach Dowdy calling for the high-low. Jackson, nice feed from Flowers. Gabe Jackson did a great job of getting the defense out of the off their feet. Gabe now 19 points in the ball game.
Keep thinking we might get to see Gabe bring down the house one of these days. I hear that he can dunk. I think his dad may
Whitehead with
pass
his
out from excitement.
Yes. I think he purposely plays a calm game to protect his dad's temper. And another turnover by the Bearcats. That's about four out of five possessions.
Yeah.
And out of bounds. Short. So to the Bearcats.
From a coaching standpoint, you know, Dexter's got a lot more tough games ahead of him. You know, you don't, even though you got the big lead, you don't like to see those kind of turnovers.
Yeah.
At this point in the game.
Jacob Crumley back in the game for the Bearcats. Flowers, nice drive. Dillinger, contact. It's going to be his third foul. Four against the Mules now. Flowers shooting two.
Mules foul number 23, Nate. Dillinger, his third.
We've got 13 points for Flowers now. Pettigo checks in for Heil for the Bearcats. Brown back in the ballgame for the Mules. Whitehead finds Brown. Good defense there by Gabe Jackson. Didn't leave his feet. Flowers pushing the tempo. The runner from the baseline won't go. Good rebound, Whitehead. Guarded by Mayo. Guzman, no contact. Going to be out of bounds off the Bearcats.
Crumley in. To take a charge.
Crumley and Jackson both on the ground, and the ball bounced off one of them and out of bounds. Guzman back to Burke. Finds Brown underneath, up top to Guzman. Over to White, or Dillinger. Now Whitehead for three. Nice shot. Whitehead now with 3 three-pointers, two here in the fourth. For 13 or 12 points in the ballgame. Oh, nice pass by Mayo. Flowers fouled by Burke. That'll be Burke's first. Team foul number five.
Mules foul number two, Jason Burke. His first team foul number five. At the line for the Bearcats, shooting two, Ethan Flowers. Into the game for the Bearcats, number 15, Dawson Casting, and number 23, Ben Sindel.
Sindel and Casting back in the game for the Bearcats.
Two more free throws. for Ethan Flowers.
Flowers now with 15 in the ballgame. Whitehead. Good hands there by Mayo, deflecting the pass from Burke, intended for Whitehead. Stays with the Mules, 4:19 to go here in the ballgame now. Dillinger, guarded by Sindel, picked up by Pettigo, over to Burke, three-pointer. So Chase Burke, his first bucket of the ballgame.
To say, I think this is the most calm I've ever seen a Coach Botch, Coach Long, Coach team.
Yes.
They realize rebuilding this year, and you take your lumps, and they always put something good out on the floor, though. They're competitive, and they go hard.
You bet. Ball's out of bounds off Ethan Flowers. He'll stay with the Mules. Hobgood in for Burke for the Mules. Kyle Crumley checking in for Sindel and Caston. Also, Gabe Jackson checking in. Ethan Flowers get a break. Jackson, good defense to contesting. Stolen by Pettigo. Pull-up jumper, high post. Won't go. Brown rebound. Whitehead. Dillinger short. Rebound Mayo. Crumley now finds Jackson. Tyler Howell from the free throw line. Won't go. Out of bounds. Ball goes to Bernie. 3 minutes now to go in the ball game.
Just got a final score from Bill Aslan. Bloomfield actually ended up losing 56-47. So they just had a little bit of a rough fourth quarter. They led that entire game.
The runner and the floater by Dillinger gives him 17 for the ball game.
See, Dillinger's got a host of family here watching him tonight.
Mayo down to Jackson. Jackson from the high post. Nice rebound from Ryan Mayo. Crumley, Mayo, he'll shoot it. Short. Bounce, bounce. Ball's going to go to the Mules. 2:24 now left in the ball game. Hobgood. Finds Brown. Dillinger. Pull up. And out won't go. Rebound Heil. He'll work the ball up or down, excuse me, over to Pettigo. Under two now. Pettigo jumper. In out won't go. Rebound Hobgood. Guzman to Whitehead, back to Hobgood, Brown, nice footwork, good work there by Brown. He gets his first bucket, now 3 points in the ball game. So he had a free throw in the first quarter. Pettigo to Mayo. Over to Heil. Mayo now, guarded by Whitehead, finds Jackson underneath. Front, spins, up, and the bucket. Okay, 4 1/4, 19, or 21 now in the ball game. And he'll get a chance for Leanne one. Gavin Brown picks up his second. Team foul number six against Bernie. Rebound Dillinger. Guzman blocked by Jackson, policed up by Brown. Just won't go. And Mayo now pushing the tempo to the other end. This is the layup. Hopgood. And I believe we might have a technical against Coach Botch. It is. So not liking all the activity there underneath the goal after Ryan Mayo's attempt. And so Pettigo will shoot the free throw. Good. Pettigo now with 10. And 11.
2 points for Jacob Pettigo. Bearcats substitution.
And I will have to agree with Coach Botch there. That was a little bit of a missed call. I think what he was arguing, Gabe coming in and kind of hanging on the rim there for a second, but I think Gabe did it more or less, try to keep from falling on somebody when he come in.
Yes.
I don't think it was an intentional.
And, you know, as Lloyd Rice reminds us all the time, you know, it's the referee's job is to manage the game.
Yeah,
part
yeah.
of that is calling fouls. But a 20-point game wasn't showboating, at least not in the opinion of the referee, so just let the play go on. Bernie had the ball. And Mayo, his second three of the game, gives him 10 points. But I understand, like you say, what Coach Botch is saying.
Yeah, I think we've had
and three,
outstanding efficient
two,
of game.
Hopgood won't go. So there's your final, 65-42 in favor of the Dexter Bearcats. We're going to take a short break for some sponsors. We'll be back with the game stats.
Can you flip it over?
While I may not be able to do your job, I'm here to help with all of your commercial or home lending. Our loans are simple and inexpensive. I'll get the job done with personal financial assistance at First National Bank, believing in community and preparing for the future.
It's nice, but you know what? I think I'm going to stick to the banking job.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative. I'm working hard in Jefferson City, fighting to support access to health care for senior citizens, fighting to remove government from our schools and allowing our teachers to teach our children without their interference. I'm working hard to support job growth in our economy, and I appreciate very much your support. If you have any questions or comments, please email me at tylerhubrecht@house.mo.gov.
Edward Jones, this is Shirley speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hey, Neil. How are you? How was the trip?
With nearly 7 million investors.
Right here. Hold on one sec.
You'd expect us to have a highly skilled call center.
Kevin, Neil Hawley's on line one.
Okay, great.
And we do. It's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
A bigger house or looking to buy your first? Go with a lender you can trust. Montgomery Bank. Our mortgage professionals are ready to help you with low rates and great service.
Folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tour us. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman, and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Tonight's game brought to you in part by Bank of Advance. Bank of Advance has four locations to serve you in Dexter, Bell City, Advance, and Chaffee. The Bank of Advance wishes luck to all teams and understands the preparation practice upon practice for each game of the long season. Bank of Advance, where a handshake still matters. Member FDIC.
When there's no light at the end of the tunnel, no hope, I just lose the will to move ahead.
God will supply you with the strength to do all that needs to be done on that day. So let go and trust in Him.
I'm so glad I don't have to go it alone anymore.
Let the Lord Jesus be your strength right now. A message from the First Baptist Church of Dexter, Missouri.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
Welcome back. Finals tabulations here real quick. Kevin, so entertain them with your lovely voice and some song.
Yeah. No, I mean, the game went about like we thought it should go tonight. You know, as we mentioned a few times, Bernie Young this year, a little bit of a rebuilding year. Did get big play out of Whitehead, Dillinger, Guzman there in the second half, continued to hustle really hard. But ultimately, you know, the key players for the Bearcats came ready to play tonight and did a good job. And once again, another big win without one of their stars, Jason Gerald.
You bet. Yes, it was all Gabe Jackson in the first half. He had 15 in the first half, 21 for the game. Ethan Flowers really got going in the third quarter, Perfect on his free throws in the fourth quarter to finish with 15. Jacob Pettigo, points every quarter for 11. 10 points. I believe Ryan Mayo had a career game Tuesday with 9, and now he backs it up with 10 points. So all good stuff. And then 4 points to Tyler Heil, 2 points each to Jacob Crumley and Dawson Casting. As a team, they were 10 of 11 from the free throw line, 91%.
That's awesome.
That's where they've been about most of the year, other than the Christmas tournament championship against Kennett. But anyway, for the Bernie Mules, it was all Nate Dillinger. He had 17 points late in the game, late in the third quarter and into the fourth. Alex Whitehead finally started finding his three-point stroke. He finished with 12, 3 three-pointers. 4 points each to Dalton Hobgood and Alex Guzman. 3 points, Jace Burke, 1 three-pointer, and then 2 points to 3 points to Gavin Brown, a free throw and a jumper there. So as a team, 9 of 14, 64%, kind of about where Bernie has been all year at the charity stripe, but atypical for Coach Botch and Jason Long team. So Bearcats getting it done at home tonight. So after a 3-game losing streak, now they're on 2 games in a row.
Yep.
And congratulations to the Bearcats. And so, again, we appreciate everybody watching tonight. Tyler, any final parting shots? Seeing none, it's time to go home. So, again, I'm Ed Gargis alongside my very good friend Kevin Bishop. Kevin, thanks for helping out tonight.
Yep, enjoyed it.
And had a lot of fun. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.